Are you tired of reading books but then failing to remember what they were about? Do you feel like you're constantly acquiring knowledge but then never really using it? Well, the solution might be the commonplace book. What is the commonplace book, you may ask? Well, it's a place where you store anything and everything that you feel is worth writing down. Most commonly, it includes things like notes from books, articles, podcasts, audiobooks, etc., quotes, poems, recipes, photos, or things that you read on social media. It used to be very popular in the past, especially among scholars and writers. We now have access to commonplace books from people like John Milton, John Locke, Virginia Woolf, Mark Twain, Leonardo da Vinci, or Isaac Newton. And it even found its way into literature. Did you know that Sherlock Holmes had his own commonplace books? Creating and keeping your own commonplace book is something that requires a lot of time and commitment. But there are multiple advantages to keeping it. If you write something down, you are more likely to remember it. If you use it also for professional development, you may use the ideas you note to later use during your career. It keeps your brain sharp, summarizing ideas, synchronizing them, etc. It can save you time if you use the materials you write down for future work. It helps me with ideas for videos, for example. It helps you find connections between ideas. And it makes your whole learning/reading experience richer. Writing down what you read also helps you identify where you might have gaps in knowledge. You can create a physical commonplace book, something similar to what, for example, Ryan Holiday has, but there are certain advantages to having it in a digital form. It is accessible 24/7, there is a full text search, you can synchronize it among multiple devices, it's easy to curate and edit as well as review, share, or backup, and you can easily connect and link ideas. It may seem more romantic to have it on paper, and it's probably more beneficial for recall purposes, but you need to go with something that you are going to be able to stick with. If it's paper, go with paper. If it's digital, go with digital. If you think you want to create your own commonplace book, start with thinking what you want to store and how you want to use what you store. I started with keeping track of books I read, including summaries, notes, and highlights, reading list, books I want to read, ideas for my YouTube channel, work-related inspiration, e.g. design ideas, marketing ideas, research data-related information, etc., parenthood articles, as well as my yearly and quarterly goals. The second step is to choose where you want to store your digital commonplace book. And that's a tough one. I think that's the main reason why I've been postponing having my own commonplace book for so long, because there are so many options and I didn't want to make the incorrect one. There is Evernote, Notion, OneNote, Research Room, and much, much more. And in the end, I decided for OneNote. It's far from perfect, but I have it already on my computer. I've been using it for other things, so I'm familiar with it. And I just wanted to make the decision and start doing it because I think having an imperfect system that I'm actually using is better than just thinking about the potential perfect system. And the third step is to start populating it, creating categories, coming up with tags that make sense so that you can easily search it. And the final step is enjoy it. Start using it to improve your work and craft. Use the ideas that you're writing down. And when you're writing down something new, look for ways how you can link it to the ideas that are already in your commonplace book. All the work that you put into creating your own commonplace book would be for nothing if you're not going to use it. So use it.